Hello, this is a quick demonstration of how to find articles on your topic using EBSCO Academic Search Complete. Here on EBSCO's homepage, you'll notice three boxes at the top for our keywords, and underneath there are a variety of options for narrowing your search. You can limit to only scholarly peer-reviewed journals. You can select your document type if, for example, you're looking for only case studies or only editorials. Another helpful limiter is publication date, so if you need articles that are from the past 5 years, you can set your date range here. There are other options as well, like publication type and language, which you can explore on your own. For this demonstration, though, we won't use any of those limiters. We're just going to use the search boxes and our keywords. In this case, I'm looking for articles about Facebook and privacy, so I'll enter those in as my search terms. You'll notice EBSCO gives you multiple search boxes, and you'll just want to put one keyword or keyword phrase in each box. So I'll type Facebook in one search box and privacy in the other, then hit search. You'll see that EBSCO tells us how many results we have, 1,251, and also how our results are being sorted by relevance to our topic. If you're looking for the newest articles on your topic, you can change this to sort by date newest. On the left-hand side of the screen, you can see some more options for refining your results. Under source type, you can see what types of sources these articles are coming from. The majority of our results are from newspapers, academic journals, and magazines, which will be the case in most library databases. Unlike Google, you won't find results from things like websites, blogs, or videos here. If your professor says you can only use academic sources, you can click on academic journals here to get rid of all the other source types. You can see that in doing this, our results have significantly decreased, and now we're down to 373, a much more manageable number. EBSCO also provides you with these subject terms that are relevant to your search, which can be helpful in narrowing down a broad topic. Again, there are other ways to limit your results here, which you should explore on your own. One last thing to notice on this page is the Ask U of L box on the right-hand side of the screen, so you can chat with a librarian right here in the database if you have any questions about your search. Once you've narrowed your search down, you can start looking through your results. When you see an article that interests you, click on the title and the record for the article will open up. The record gives you a lot of information about the article, like the authors, source, more subject terms, and an abstract, which is helpful in determining if an article is relevant before reading the whole thing. On the right-hand side of this page are tools for printing the article or emailing it to yourself, as well as a cite button that can help you write your citation for the article. For example, if you use MLA, you can scroll down and there's your MLA citation. You'll still want to check this against the style guide to make sure everything is correct, but it's a great place to start and you won't have to start your citations from scratch. So once you've looked over an article record and read the abstract, and the article sounds like it will be helpful in your research, you'll want to look for a full text button to read the article. In the best case scenario, you'll see a PDF full text or HTML full text on the left-hand side here. If there is no full text button, you can click on Find It at U of L, which will open up a search to all of our library resources, both online and in print, to see if we have it. Whenever you can't find an article, though, don't hesitate to ask a librarian, either in person or using the chat box. We can help you get an article, even if we don't own it here at U of L. This was a quick introduction to using EBSCO Academic Search Complete. Remember to ask a librarian if you have any questions. We're here to help.